That means Albuquerque Police Chief Ray Schultz is joining us to take your phone calls, and you can go ahead and call in. The numbers are there. But we want to first ask you about the transition. I found this interesting, that Darren White used to work for you.
He did. When he first moved to Albuquerque and started his career in law enforcement, he worked for me. So what I've been teasing him about is a lot of this gray hair that I have was a result of him working for me, so what goes around comes around. So I think I'm going to get even now a little bit.
Now, you also have met with the mayor, R.J. Berry, and you have some meetings already set up. Tell me about some of the focus areas.
Well, the mayor was very clear when he was running for office that he wanted property crime to be his number one initiative. Over the past couple of weeks, we've been talking about property crimes, about what we can do even more to put a lid on the property crime offenses that continue to occur. Auto theft, burglary, top priorities, as well as some of the simple things like petty larcenies. We're working very closely with all the retailers, especially now during the holiday season. We've got our holiday mall tax plans in place at both Cottonwood and Coronado, Uptown, and some of the big box retailers. So we're going to continue to go after the property crime offenders. We're working with the district attorney's office, make sure those folks get prosecuted. And if they're in jail or in prison, they can't commit more crimes. So that's the message that we're going to send.
Okay, very good. We have a caller already, and this is Gary in Albuquerque. Gary, thanks for calling in. What's your question for the chief?
Hi. Well, I was wondering about people that are crossing the street in between cars at the intersections. They've just stopped using the crosswalks, and it's getting real dangerous up here in the North Central. I'm sure it's all over.
That is a problem, and that's something that we work very closely with SunTran, and the bus drivers will tell us very often if they see people crossing the middle of the street, most of the time they're running to grab a bus or something like that. We have been doing operational plans, San Mateo and Central. We've been there. We've actually issued in a couple months about 80 citations for jaywalking, and people think, well, jaywalking is not a big deal. Well, it is, because it disrupts the flow of traffic, and it's also very dangerous. We've also been up in the Knob Hill area, Old Town, so we'll continue to watch that. And if you see problems specifically, give us a call. You can call 242-COPS or call my office at 768-2200, and we'll make sure we address it.
Okay, very good. Earlier in the newscast, we talked about hot cars, how people are warming up their cars and people are taking them. You've had quite a few incidents.
We have. Just the last couple days, I think there's been three vehicles stolen from folks' driveways. And what they're doing, people are going out, starting up their cars, running inside to grab a cup of coffee, and then their cars being stolen. One of the things that we've got going on right now is we've got our helicopter, the airplane, and the sheriff's department helicopter as well. They're flying in the morning. So when we get those calls of someone that, you know, the car has just recently been stolen, we can get someone overhead. And we've been successful. We have recovered some of those vehicles. But the key is we don't want people doing that, because unfortunately some of the cars that we've recovered haven't been in the same condition as they were when they left them in their driveway. These folks steal the cars. They have no problem in running from us. They have no problem jumping curbs or going off-road, and the vehicle gets damaged. So the key there is if either don't warm it up or stay in the car, or buy one of those remote systems that you can actually have the car locked. If somebody puts it in gear, it will automatically stall the car. So there's some safety systems that people can get to do it and not take a chance on having their car stolen.
All right, we have another call. This is Helen in Albuquerque. Helen, thanks for calling in. What's your question?
I guess it's more of a peeve. Why are people allowed to make U-turns at intersections, major intersections?
Well, actually, they're not supposed to. There is a city ordinance that says in business and commercial areas, you are not supposed to be allowed to make a U-turn. However, because they're not properly marked, we don't normally issue citations for that. That's one of the things that we are working with traffic engineers, and you are starting to see more and more no U-turn signs pop up around the city, especially as intersections are restriped or the new signs go up. Traffic engineers are looking at those intersections and posting them if appropriate. But you're right. You should not be making U-turns at major intersections. I think we need to do a lot more work in the area of education.
Okay, good. Chief, thanks so much for coming in. Congratulations on staying with the force.
Thank you. I look forward to it. A lot of good things are going to happen. I guarantee it.
All right, great. Thanks a lot. We'll be